Thank you for joining me in the History of Science Collections of the University of Oklahoma Libraries. Let's look at some of the treasures in the OU Galileo collection. Galileo's first printed book was a manual on the operation of a geometrical and military compass. The instrument contained scales of his own innovative design, useful for an astonishing variety of calculations in the field. The Oklahoma copy of Galileo's first printed work contains his own marginal notes, including corrections, which were quickly incorporated into later copies of the first printed edition. Because it was the first copy off the printing press, see how the fresh type bit deeply into the paper? OU holds Galileo's own copy of the first and rarest of Galileo's books. Galileo's second printed book was a defense against the calumnies and impostures of Baldassare Capra. Capra had plagiarized Galileo's first book and published instructions for making Galileo's compass. The OU copy of Galileo's second printed book also contains Galileo's handwriting. It is inscribed by Galileo to a friend who was a physician in Venice. In his third printed book, The Starry Messenger, Galileo published the first observations of the heavens made with the telescope. The Sidereus Nuncius catapulted Galileo into international celebrity status almost overnight. In this work, Galileo demonstrated that the moon has mountains. Galileo also discovered four satellites revolving around Jupiter, printing more than 60 observations of their positions from night to night. What we call the Galilean moons, Galileo called the Medicean stars. Jupiter stood for the Grand Duke of Tuscany, and the four satellites stood for the Grand Duke's four sons. That is how you would write a grant application in the 17th century. But the book was printed in such haste that Galileo came up with this idea only after the first pages were already printed. So you can see that he pasted the new name on top of this previously printed page. The book's title, Sidereus Nuncius, means ambassador from the stars and refers to Galileo himself. The four satellites of Jupiter were a message from the heavens delivered by none other than Galileo for the honor of Cosimo Medici, the new Grand Duke of Tuscany. Within months, Galileo joined Cosimo's court in Florence, where he inscribed this copy to his friend Gabriel Cibera, a poet in the Medici court. Galileo next published a description of sunspots. At the top of the title page, we can see Galileo's geometrical compass and the telescope. By tracking the motion of sunspots across the face of the sun, Galileo proved that they were on the sun's surface, not little planets orbiting nearby. In response to gathering criticism, Galileo wrote a short reconciliation of Scripture and Copernicanism, which circulated in manuscript as the Letter to the Grand Duchess Christina. Galileo argued that the purpose of Scripture is to tell us how to go to heaven, not how the heavens go. The Scripture never errs, but its interpreters do err. And read rightly, Scripture and science will never conflict. There is a unity of truth. That which is obscure, figurative language, should be explained by that which is clear, mathematical demonstrations. To show the traditional basis of his approach, Galileo cited Saint Augustine throughout. In 1623, Galileo's supporter and friend, Cardinal Maffeo Barberini, became Pope Urban VIII. The election of Barberini seemed to assure Galileo of support at the highest level in the church. At the top of the title page is the Barberini family crest, showing three busy bees. Galileo dedicated this book to the new pope and argued that mathematics is the language of nature. This is the famous Dialogue on the Two Chief Systems of the World, published in 1632, the book for which Galileo was put on trial. If we look closely at the frontispiece, Aristotle and Ptolemy on the left hold an Earth-centered armillary sphere. On the right, Copernicus, dressed in Catholic garb, holds a sun-centered model of the universe. Galileo was already famous across Europe and didn't have to write in Latin. He wrote this in Italian, and it was an immediate bestseller. The book is a literary masterpiece cast in the form of a Platonic dialogue between three characters, Salviati, Sagredo, and Simplicio. Galileo obtained official permission to publish this book from the Vatican and from the censors in Florence. In a private conversation, the Pope also gave him permission to publish it, so long as he kept the conclusions hypothetical. The annotation says that this figure of falling bodies is in error. It is upside down. The printer's error is corrected in the second edition. This is Galileo's own handwriting in his own copy of the dialogue. Here is a new sentence by Simplicio to go before a long speech by Salviati, again written in Galileo's own hand. It is almost as if we were in Galileo's study, looking over his shoulder in the crucial months before his trial. Far from Rome, in Oklahoma today, one may now hold the very copy Galileo held in his hands. In addition to all of Galileo's first editions, the OU Galileo collection includes later editions and translations. This is the first English translation of any of Galileo's works. It includes the Dialogue on the Two Chief Systems of the World and Galileo's letter to the Grand Duchess Christina. The volume is charred and blackened around the edges. Fewer than 50 copies survive, as most perished in the Great Fire of London in 1665. Under house arrest, Galileo turned his attention to a number of topics that had long interested him. This is his masterwork of physics, the Discourse on Two New Sciences. Galileo's first new science is the science of tensile strength. Did you know that Galileo's works included a study of the tensile strength of bones? Galileo argued that the bones of giants would not have the same shape as ours. Galileo's second new science is motion, including the motion of falling bodies and the parabolic trajectories of projectiles. Two New Sciences was Galileo's last book. While many major libraries hold one or a few first editions of Galileo, OU holds the entire set of 12 first editions. Science is a story. What stories would you want to hear and tell about Galileo?